what we see here came from Segovia many years ago. And so therefore, that's the reason it's Santinovi, known as the monastery. As some people had asked me sometime if there's any monks here, I said no, because the reason that this is here is almost strange. It's a miracle, because someone brought it from Segovia in Spain. It didn't come to be a church here, but circumstances, it's in our hands now, Episcopalian, because the fact is that they added some bite from one person to the other and reconstructed it here. That's why we have this beautiful edifice here at the moment. A time, this in the beginning belonged to the Roman Catholic Church, and so therefore they were in a dire situation economically, financially, and so they had to sell some of their property back in the 13th and 14th century so as to get money, because as we know, you know, money is, we need money anywhere, and they had all this and they did not have enough personnel or monks to be in this place, and it was getting out of hand in a sense, because having no one who was still being monks, you know, it was just staying there and they had to turn in other things, so they had to sell it. So some philanthropists who had the money bought it. It took a long while, as you'll see in the history, getting it here and all that. It did not come to belong to the Episcopal Church at the beginning. It's just a matter of circumstances that we have it in our hands. So there's a big difference as far as concern being there and being here. Because if you notice what is known as the cloister, this was exactly where the monks used to go around and say their prayers, because they had three vows that they made, which was that of, you know, to be in prayer and to care for the world and the community around them. And right over there, you'll see the chapel that is now the chapel. That was where they used to have their meals after saying their prayers. So in a sense, it's a big difference, but it still has the same connotation religiously, let us put it that way.
Bishop Henry Luddy purchased the property for the Diocese of South Florida, later to become the Diocese of Central, Southeast, and Southwest Florida. Shortly thereafter, when the three dioceses ran into financial difficulties, the monastery was put up for sale, and the parishioners of St. Bernard feared a second move. During the bishopric of Reverend James Duncan, Robert Pentland Jr., a multimillionaire banker, philanthropist, and benefactor of many Episcopal churches, purchased the cloisters and presented them to the parish of St. Bernard de Clairvaux.